there. My name is Maria, and I am going to present to you today how to sell your maid service for top dollar. First of all, thank you to Amar for inviting me back to the second annual ZenMaid Maid Service Summit. So cool. Thank you, Amar. A little bit about me. So my name is Maria Dorian, and I am the current founder of Taskaway Virtual Assistant. I had a maid service in Austin, Texas that I sold. I ran for about 14 years, and I sold it at about, I think we ended up $740,000-ish run rate around there. Actually, no, I think it was $840,000, sold it at $740,000. So $840,000 run rate, sold it at about $740,000 in yearly revenue. Currently run Taskaway Virtual Assistant, and I'm also the co-founder of Quality Driven Software, and that's another company that I sold my shares to. So I know a little bit about how to sell a maid service. Today, I'm mainly going to talk to you about actionable steps that you can do today that will directly impact what you get at the very end when you're ready to sell your maid service. So thank you so much for joining my talk. If you have any questions, like after you hear the talk, if you're like, oh gosh, you know, I could really use a referral for a software or for, you know, a broker, because I'll talk to you a little bit about my broker. I went the broker route. Really, if there's anything that I say in this presentation that you're thinking, oh, I want to know a little bit more about that, then definitely reach out and I will give you my contact info on the very last slide. So again, we're going to talk about how to sell your maid service for top dollar. So one thing that I can tell you is I know you might be in business, you know, 2 months or 12 years. It really doesn't matter. But when you're ready to sell, most people think, okay, I'm ready to sell. Let's now get everything ready. But I'm going to say that really you should always have your end goal in mind, really when making any decisions, but especially when you're selling. And so if you know that you want to eventually sell your maid service, definitely have your strategy in mind. And also know that decisions that you make today will definitely impact what you ultimately sell your maid service for. One little trick that I kind of use to keep myself accountable, and I know this is a little weird, a little counterintuitive, but it really worked for me, is when you make a decision, always have your potential buyers in mind. And so what I mean by that is when you're just in the day-to-day, when you're trying to figure out, you know, decisions, you know, should I fire the employee? Should I give that person the money back? If you kind of think, okay, what would a potential buyer like to see? Like, what is this decision going to impact? And what will my potential buyers think of this decision? That helped me in huge ways. And I think I had that thought process for a good 2 to 3 years before I actually made the decision to sell. So running your business, you know, the most efficient as possible should always be on your mind. And what that means is there a faster way to get things done? Is there a better way to implement it? Do we need to update our software? In other words, are we using pen and paper and Maid calendars? Is there a software that, you know, might cost a little bit more than what we're currently paying, but at the end of it, you know, we put more money in our pockets? All of those decisions will ultimately impact what you sell your maid service for. And you always obviously want to optimize all of your procedures. Decisions, you know, day-to-day decisions that just doesn't seem like it, but really will have an impact, are things like, you know, if you have a client that is complaining, and if this decision is, hey, do I give them, you know, money back in order to avoid that bad Yelp or Google review, or do I stand my ground because I'm right and no, they don't deserve money back? How will that decision impact the final end sale? It actually has a huge impact. And I'll give you an example, even on the Yelp. So if I'm looking at somebody that wasn't happy with their cleaning, and my option is to either, you know, say, nope, I'm not giving them a penny back. There's nothing I can do to help them. And as a result, they leave a bad Yelp review. Well, when you go to sell your business and a potential buyer is looking at your online presence and they see all these negative Yelp reviews, what is that going to say to a potential buyer, right? It's not going to look very good. And so if you're looking at, hey, do I, you know, go back and do that reclean, or do I give them money back? That might be well worth it, right? things like documentation of employee issues, doing write-up and, you know, following your disciplinary ladder, what that can actually have a huge impact on your unemployment rates. And when it's time to go sell your business, then what does your unemployment numbers look like? Keeping a good culture. What that means, if you've got a great, strong culture and your employee turnover is low, that's going to look good to a potential buyer. The better that your business looks to a potential buyer, the more you can sell it for, right? So our goal here is to do all of the right things on a daily basis to where at the end of it, you can sell it for more money. Your market is going to have a little bit of impact on that, of course, right? If we're in a down market, then you're not going to be able to sell it for a bunch of money. But obviously, assuming that, you know, the market is great, we want to do everything to make our business look amazing. And again, that comes down to the everyday, the small things that you do on a daily basis. Another really good example of that is just know that a potential buyer doesn't really want to buy a job. And so what I mean by that is if you're currently, you know, as the owner cleaning homes every day, how is that going to look to a potential buyer? Are they going to want to clean houses every day? Are they going to want to take over your job? Probably not. They're going to want to know that, first of all, they're going to want to know that you're not the secret sauce in the business, that it all runs itself. And, you know, potentially the very next day after they buy it, they can go on vacation because the business runs itself. So if you're cleaning homes every day, that's not going to look very good to a potential buyer. And that will have a direct impact on what you can sell it for. Lowering your expenses while increasing your profits. That's huge. Things like firing fast and hiring slow. And that's actually not just for employees. That's for customers and vendors too. In other words, if there's a vendor that's constantly costing you money or not delivering products on time, then you want to go ahead and just get rid of them, you know, as quickly as possible. So yes, so what you do today will actually count. So again, make wise decisions, correct mistakes quickly, change what needs to be changed. So one little trick on that is if you have an issue in your business, I always kind of play this little mental game. So an issue came up. So I don't know. Oh, you know what? We were in Texas. So let's say that we were constantly leaving the air conditioner on. So and Mrs. Smith called and said, hey, we were out on vacation for a week. You guys left my AC on. So what can we change to make sure that that issue never happens again? So that was like a little trick I learned that, you know, we change a system and that way the issue that happened just never happened again. So what policy, what system needs to change so that the issues don't repeat themselves? And really the more that you have, you know, less things go wrong on a day-to-day basis, the less stressful, the more money you make. And at the end, that all kind of comes around to that sale price. A good friend of mine, Derek Christian, he says, do you want to be right? Do you want to be successful? Obviously, implement systems, and more systems. Your systems are going to be your policies, your ways of doing things. One huge recommendation I have is if you don't use ClickUp, definitely that's a great software to use to help you with those systems. And again, don't create a job for yourself. Create a business that runs without you. Obviously, being, you know, running a referral agency that offers virtual assistance, I'm huge on hiring a VA to kind of help you through the day-to-day. Okay, so when you are ready to sell your business, there's a few things that you need to do. You have to decide when is the right time. You're going to have to decide if the business is even sellable. Do you go for a broker or do you self-list? You're going to have to decide what type of sale. Are you wanting an all cash up front? Are you going to allow your potential buyer a payout agreement or maybe a combination where you do like a revenue share? You've got to arrive at an asking price, and that's going to be, you know, your evaluation, your determination. You're going to have an appraisal, figure out what the business is actually worth. And then you're actually going to want to decide what to do after the sale. So usually, I mean, it can take gosh, anywhere from a year to a few years to actually sell the business. In my case, that's not the case. That was actually quite the exact opposite. I think I listed it and 3 days later, the potential buyer came, and a month, my business was gone and I did not have a plan. So you actually want to have a plan because you just don't know if it's going to be a few years or, like in my case, if it's going to go lightning fast. So decide what you're going to do after you sell. So I'll kind of go through some of these. So when is the right time? That's going to be really important. For me, we thought it was the right time and I decided to go with a broker. So I met with my broker. How I found my broker, I can go into that a little bit. I didn't really know, you know, how the sell of what selling a business was going to be like. So I went with a broker. Happened to, you know, search brokers, you know, for sale, and they're, you know, brokers, sell of the business brokers in Austin, Texas. This particular person, his name is Jim Pringle. I just happened to like his last name. And so I called him and he was really the right fit for me right from day one. He was amazing. When I met with him the first time though, he determined that it was not the right time. He right away just saw that I was actually not ready to sell. And so he said, look, just, you've got more work to do. There's more work that needs to be done on the business. He can really tell that I wasn't emotionally ready to sell. So then I think we came back about 2 years later. I called him and I said, okay, can we have another conversation? And this time he said, yeah, you can tell we were ready. So you always want to sell when your business is on a steady incline and profitable. You also want to take into account the current economy. So obviously, if the economy crashes, then that's probably not a good time to list a business for sale. You'll also need to decide what to sell it for. And there's so many different factors that go into that. They'll look at other businesses, similar businesses that are up for sale in your area and on a national scale. You'll want to decide, you know, do you go with a broker or do you self-list? A lot of people just will list their business on, you know, Biz Buy Sell is just one example. There's pros and cons for each. For me, a pro with a broker was just somebody that just had experience. And I like the fact that somebody was going to be able to, you know, walk me through the whole entire process. It costs money. It costs a lot of money. I think mine was 6% of the sale price, if I remember right, but they can go as much as, you know, 10%. I have heard people pay 10%, up to 10% for a broker. So I hired mine on expertise. I like personally that he had a vested interest in selling the business for top dollar. And funny enough, the person that bought my business, he only wanted to deal with a broker. It was actually an outside buyer. He was not in the industry. He only wanted to deal with a broker. So I kind of got lucky there. And like I mentioned, you know, you can just list your business on, you know, Biz Buy Sell, hire somebody to appraise the business and hire a lawyer, and you can get it done without that third party. Usually the standard price in our industry is 2.5 to 4.5 times the yearly profit. One thing that I will tell you as far as cleaning up, once you decide to sell a business, then there's going to be a lot of cleanup. You're going to have to clean up your books. I will tell you that there is nothing that will kill a deal faster than books that are messy. If the potential buyer has questions that the books aren't readily answered, they're just going to lose faith. They're going to lose trust, and business deals really can die rather quickly. So you'll definitely want to make sure that your books are cleaned up, give them to an accountant. You'll want to make sure that all your training manuals are up to date. We talked about systems. Make sure that, you know, all your systems are in place. Anything that gets in the way of running a self-running business, you want to clean those up before you list your business. So once you've made the decision to sell, there's going to be a whole lot that you're going to have to collect. And actually, I didn't find that this process was difficult. Because if you are constantly upkeeping and everything's always in order, then it's actually not bad at all. And if you have a broker, obviously the broker will give you a long list of things to collect. But so you're going to have to collect, you know, businesses that are for sale nationwide and locally, and that's all the appraisal reports. You'll need to get your profit and loss statement. You'll need to get different statements. For example, your workers' comp, they just want to make sure that, you know, there's no huge claims out there or pending claims. They want to know that you're in good standing. If you collect sales tax, you'll get a letter. A letter actually from your sales tax that says, you know, everything's in good standing, nothing owed, no sales tax due. Your unemployment rate, the potential buyer is going to want to know that. Of course, the lower the better. And so when we talk about things that are impactful now, a low unemployment rate, that's something that you can do now that's super important. And so instead of just, you know, firing everybody without, you know, warning, you can help keep that unemployment rate low by following your disciplinary ladder and doing the warnings and the write-ups and the pay decreases, all of that to make sure that you don't actually end up paying a higher unemployment rate than necessary. You'll get your company stats, your bookkeeping. You will need 3 years of financial earnings, all of your expense reports, and you'll also put together a short summary of your business. So your summary is all of your strengths, all of your weaknesses. Obviously, when I say your strengths, that's your company's strengths, your company weaknesses, what's going to happen to you after you leave. In other words, are you willing to stay on as a consultant? Are you going to be able to help oversee the transition? Other things that I included in my summary, gave an overview of the business. I gave an overview of my competition, talked about operations, and that's key players in the business, their roles, how long they've been with me, their responsibilities, what made them amazing people. So I think I had like 5 office managers. I just listed them all, what their roles were, strengths, weaknesses, what they did, all of that good stuff. I laid out my marketing plan, like who my target market was. Also included, you know, what I was currently doing for marketing, what my SEO ranking looked like, everything dealing with marketing. I just put it in a nice summary for them. My average ticket price, my churn rate, and that's for employees and for customers. Basically, you'll want to gather everything and put it in a summary and just hand it to the potential buyers on what your business is. And you will have a walkthrough, which I'll talk to you about that in a minute. But the point of a summary is to get your company to look really good on paper. All right, so there's a lot of factors that influence the asking and that final sales price. Your profitability, huge. How scalable the business is, your client count. So if you have a lot of, you know, commercial clients versus a lot of smaller residential, that's going to have a bigger impact. Not that obviously having a commercial business is bad, but a potential buyer might say, okay, look, if you've got, you know, 10 huge accounts versus 100 little accounts, that might have an effect on what you sell the business for. How long you've been in business, how long clients have been with you, your turnover, your expenses, any business debts, your brand recognition, your online presence, your role in the business. We already talked about how, we want to make sure that your potential buyer is getting a business and not just inheriting a job. Other similar companies in your area around the country and what they sold for and how clean your books are. At the end of the day, selling your business is just basically sales. So we need to be able to, you know, make your business look great to your buyer. And so working in the business, you don't want that. You want to make sure that you're constantly working on your business. So for me, one thing that really, really helped my case, and this is something that my broker really helped with getting the potential buyer to see, is I did a lot of traveling. I did a lot of road trips. I went to New Zealand and Australia for a month and a half, went to Florida for 3 weeks. And really during all of that time, I hardly had any, you know, contact with the office. And that's so that's great because that tells a potential buyer, hey, once Maria leaves, this thing keeps going. So that's super important. So once the potential buyer sees everything on paper and they're like, yeah, they, you know, they're liking what they see, you guys will probably arrange a site visit. So a site visit is just exactly what it sounds like. They'll come to your office if you have one. They'll, you know, you'll give them a tour, talk to them a little bit about, you know, your company. A little bit of tips on that is have a checklist on things that are must mention, you know, like must mention to the potential buyer. So you'll have a show and tell. You'll showcase all the cool things that drive your company. So for us, we had a lot of really cool things on the walls and, you know, numbers and all the employees, you know, pictures and little awards and stuff that they had gotten. So we want to showcase all of that. You want to highlight your business, any media mentions, any awards that you've gotten. During this time, it is important to not talk about numbers though. That should be done outside, you know, obviously in writing and with your broker. Let the buyer ask you questions. And really the point of this meeting is you want to justify a higher asking price during this time. So your job is to make the business look as appealing as possible. And so during that time is when we talked about, you know, my role in the business and how, you know, really my role at that time was just all I did was the marketing. I only worked one day a week. Actually, well, I worked a lot more than one day a week, but I only went into my office one day a week, did a lot of traveling. So little things like that was mentioned during that walkthrough. So once the offer is made, then I guess it kind of depends on if you have one offer or multiple, but you'll get to decide who you sell to and why. One thing that a lot of people don't know is that a lot of times, as far as asking price, people that are outside of the industry are usually willing to pay a little bit more versus somebody that's already knows, you know, everything about the maid service. And they might even know that they're basically scrapping all of your stuff and, you know, revamping it to, you know, to their things. And so a lot of times somebody in the industry just isn't willing to pay as much as somebody outside. Right now there, if you guys ever need a referral for somebody that's currently buying cleaning services in the industry, definitely ask about that because I know somebody. And then of course I've got a great broker that I can refer you guys to. So once an offer is made, you'll get to decide who you want to sell to. Just a little bit of tips there. Keep your current staff in mind. If you don't potentially like the buyers, chances are your staff won't either. Selling to the right person is obviously going to be important, especially if you're, you know, negotiating a payout agreement. I always say follow your gut instinct on all things. So I know for me, we had one potential buyer that, you know, honestly, all his financials look great. In fact, he was a multimillionaire, really, really nice couple. We thought, gosh, my office manager would love them. I thought the staff would love him, but I kept getting this like gut feeling that I don't know that, you know, I can't pinpoint what might be wrong, but I don't know if this is the right buyer. And what was interesting is I did take that to the broker and the broker's like, you know, that's interesting that you said that because I had that same kind of funny gut feeling. So we ended up not selling to that potential person. For us, we had a bidding war. It got to the point where the broker was, you know, literally telling potential buyers, if you aren't willing to offer Maria full asking price in cash, don't bother. And that was a great place to be because then you're able to really, really choose your potential buyer. Again, for me, the sale went lightning fast. I didn't have a plan in place. So literally after the business sold, I seriously was like, okay, now what are we doing? But all of that is to say that I think for us, we did a lot of things right. We ended up selling for, I think it was 4.5 times my profit. And things that I did to get that final sale price, I got all cash, full asking price. And like I said, it was kind of a bidding war. But things that I did to get that final price is actually everything that I talked to you about. It was a lot of really good decisions, a lot of thought, a lot of doing the right things throughout the whole entire 14 years that I truly believe kind of all led to getting that final asking price. I even sold it a little bit above what it was worth. And I remember my broker actually saying, you know, I can't justify that price. He said, when I look at, you know, what the business is worth and what other businesses are selling for, he said, I need help. I need your help in really justifying that price. And so it was, you know, it was a process on, look, this is how amazing my company is. You know, we've got employees that have been with us 2, 3, 5, 8 years. I don't do a lot in the business. We have amazing, you know, Yelp reviews. I think at the time we had almost all 5, like, you know, you're 4.5 on Yelp, 218 reviews on Yelp. Obviously Google was, you know, almost 5 stars there. It was actually really hard to find, you know, a negative review on my company. Our unemployment rate was like a 0.1, whatever, like the lowest it can go. Out of 14 years, we never lost an unemployment case ever. Everything was profitable. Our SEO was good. So all the systems and were in place. So I really truly believe that that's what got us to that final asking price. And that's actually why I think this topic is really kind of passionate and why I wanted to share with you today. So if there's anything that you heard in this talk that you want more information on, definitely let me know. As far as systems in place, as far as making sure that you're not selling a job to a potential person, I'm always going to say delegate, delegate, and delegate. And part of that is hiring a virtual assistant. So if you guys ever need help with that process, please let me know. I'd be happy to get you somebody that's, you know, that knows the maid service and is trained on your company to get you out of working on the day to day. Thank you so much. And let me know if you guys need anything.